Why are you proud of yourself?
I have written all these knowledge reports in 1 week.
In 1 week?
Mm-hmm.
You're really in ethics.
Yes.
I congratulate you. That's impressive. I'm glad you're out spotting suppression in our church and writing it up.
Well, a lot of these are on my friends.
Well, friends, look, if you have to write KRs on them, they may not be your friends.
They are refusing to unfriend and unlike things. They're liking Tony Ortega. They've got a like on his site.
Oh, then they're not your friends.
And they're reading hostile sites.
Oh, I've unfriended people who read the internet. I don't want to hear it. Don't want to see it. Don't want to talk about it. I'll tell you what I'm proud of myself. Mm. My Rolex watch collection, sold it. Donated part of the money to get a $10,000 20th anniversary IES commemorative pin.
Oh.
And when I get it, that pin's going right there.
Ah,
you know why? Mm. That pin sets me apart from all other Scientologists who don't donate $10,000 for the pin. That $10,000 pin says, I'm there behind you, Mr. Miscavige, COB. I got your back.
And in that way, to put it bluntly, we booby-trapped the whole psychiatric ecosystem.
Not like these other thieby weedy people go, oh, I'm not going to step up for a $10,000 pin. No, that pin, that's my identity.
Mm. What status do you get for that?
It's just a pin. It means you're supporting the 20th anniversary of the IAS. It means you're there, that you believe in the cause. So there's no status. That's what the other money's for when I sold my Rolex watch collection.
You shouldn't be telling me this. I'm going to knowledge report that you held back some of that money.
Well, no, I'm going
to. You only gave $10,000 to the church.
No, the other money's to raise my IAS patron status.
Ah.
There's no holdback with me here. The money
I
had to count for the bridge. Superpower building, cornerstone member. Mm-hmm. There's so much important work to be done that I think I can put the bridge on hold this lifetime.
As of this evening, Scientology.org is in the top 10th of the top 1% of the most visited sites on the net, and by far and away the most logged on religious site. Although the real hosannas go to those who heard the calling, with the multitudes clicking in surpassing 24 million, and that's just this year.
You know, I even wrote a knowledge report on myself.
Really?
Yeah, I called it Things That Should Not Be.
Wow.
And you know why I wrote that report?
Why is that?
Out of sheer curiosity.
Yeah?
I went and read the Truth Rundown.
I don't know what that is.
Oh.
I don't read the internet.
Oh.
Don't tell me about it, please.
Okay.
If it's on Theta Online.
Okay. All right. Are you going to knowledge report me for telling you about the Truth Rundown?
I have to, but it will be totally NARC when I write my KR. You understand.
Okay. I have a request.
Yes.
If you have to KR me, I understand. But can you please not CC Free Winds, the Flagland Base, and Julian Schwartz of AOLA, because when you do that, Julian calls you up and demands to come over to search your computers. Isn't that unlawful search and seizure of your Sixth Amendment?
We're in the church. Wog Law doesn't apply, and I'm going to have to put that in the KR so that Julian and the flagship know. You might have some OWs you need to write up. It's just for the greatest good.
You know, it may not be safe talking to you if what I say is going to be reported.
But the most enthralling story is 119 million people introduced L. Ron Hubbard's tales in just the last 18 months. But of course, In the beginning was the Word, and that Word issued forth as the golden age of knowledge. First came LRH's milestone congresses, whereupon it was the very foundation of our religion with the basics, while as for the numbers availing themselves of those materials, it's no less than 81 million LRH books and lectures this decade, far surpassing our first 50 years combined. And if it all sounds stratospheric, you're right, because stack them end to end and you're literally heading for deep space. Meanwhile, for the ground level view, take all tech course completions from the 1990s, and your basics are now 10 times the whole lot of them. There's more, because the last 10 years will be further remembered as the decade we went global, which ultimately means 4.6 million translated pages of LRH, and that's 12 times greater than all earlier decades combined. And when you count the editions and count the titles, even the Guinness Book of World Records proclaimed LRH the most translated author, most published author, and author with the most audiobooks.
I believe there is a conspiracy.
Oh, there's definitely a conspiracy.
Did you see the statistics that COB gives us?
From neighborhood cops who work party drug alleys, to the federal units along the trafficking corridors, from prison camps along the rim of hell, to the warehouse penitentiaries all over America, from frontline Middle Eastern squads, to rear guard African battalions, from competition bicycle tracks, to high speed waterways, from Mexico's National Congress, to Taiwan's Ministry of Education, and heads of state all over the Americas, total it all, and we're now distributing the way to happiness at 2 times the previous decade, while to carry it into the future, it's no less than 250 new chapters across 154 nations for this New Year celebration, 2010.
Donated to reach people with the way to happiness. And yet, even though we've reached billions of people with the way to happiness and the message of planetary salvation, they're still in theta in the media and on the internet. So yes, this can only mean that there's a conspiracy. Why isn't our message of dissemination going forward? I have a theory.
Who?
The Vatican.
The Vatican?
And the Freemasons. And the Illuminati. Or some combination thereof. Some dire forces are opposing us.
I think it's the pharmaceutical industry. I think Eli Lilly is doing a payback.
Well, they're part of it. It's very tangled and sinister. Because COB, RTC David Miscavige, is putting so much effort into planetary expansion and clearing that there has to be some active hidden enemy.
Yes, yes.
Maybe even some people in our own church.
Mm. Mm.
That's why we need OSA doing more sec checks, not less.
Mm.
So I'm tired of hearing these people saying too much sec checking. No, there's not enough.